SpaceX's upgrades at the Starship launch pad were also put to the test Saturday. The rocket made a big mess when it launched on its first test flight in April, when the blast from the Raptor engines blew a hole in the concrete underneath the pedestal where the rocket sits before launch. Massive chunks of concrete were strewn across hundreds of acres around the launch pad, denting tanks and carving craters in the surrounding mud flats. Clouds of dust and sand fell on communities several miles away. This is something SpaceX didn't want to repeat with the second test flight, so engineers installed a water deluge system at the pad to protect it from similar damage again. In the final seconds of the countdown, the deluge system released more than 100,000 gallons of fresh water through channels built into a steel plate installed underneath the pad's circular launch mount. The fountain-like flow of water was supposed to absorb the heat and acoustic energy from the super heavy engines. By all early accounts, the deluge system worked as it should. There were no chunks of large debris around the launch pad after Saturday's liftoff. This will reduce the cleanup SpaceX has to do before moving the booster and upper stage to the pad for the next Starship test flight, preserving an opportunity for another Starship launch within the next few months. After Starship launch, Elon Musk responded on X post and said, "Launch pad is in great shape. Overall, this was a huge improvement over the first test flight. SpaceX showed much greater reliability in the stage zero, with none of the parts of stage zero malfunctioning during the launch. The launch pad seemingly fared much better this time around as well." Various live streams from the launch pad did not show giant chunks of debris flying after liftoff, which can help set SpaceX up for a much faster return to flight for Starship following their mishap investigation. While SpaceX's philosophy is to fly as soon as possible and learn from any mistakes, NASA will require a long string of successful missions before the agency will deem it safe to put astronauts aboard. SpaceX will no doubt resolve the issues that derailed Saturday's flight, but every delay poses a threat to NASA's moon landing timeline. A few things left undone. Ultimately, though, SpaceX didn't hit all of its objectives Saturday. The booster blew up soon after detaching from the Starship upper stage, and it wasn't clear whether it malfunctioned on its own, or if it might have been damaged from getting blasted by superheated exhaust from the upper stage engines. A potential risk of the hot staging maneuver Musk identified before the test launch. The destruction of the Starship upper stage in the final seconds of its engine burn also eliminated a chance to test the ship's heat shield. If the mission went perfectly, the flight would have ended about an hour and a half after liftoff, with splashdown of Starship in the Pacific Ocean. The spacecraft was covered in thousands of ceramic tiles to protect its stainless steel structure from the heat of re-entry. Some of the tiles appeared to fall off the ship during the climb into space, but SpaceX didn't immediately confirm video indications of this. SpaceX needs to safely recover the Starship upper stage on future test flights to meet the company's goal of developing a fully reusable rocket, but that will have to wait a little longer after the outcome of Saturday's mission. But a SpaceX post on social media said, "With a test like this, success comes from what we learn, and today's test will help us improve Starship's reliability as SpaceX seeks to make life multiplanetary." NASA Administrator Bill Nelson also was supportive. "Congrats to the teams who made progress on today's flight test," he tweeted. "Spaceflight is a bold adventure demanding a can-do spirit and daring innovation. Today's test is an opportunity to learn then fly again. It's not yet known why the Super Heavy booster broke apart, or why the Starship upper stage apparently failed just before or after engine shutdown. But SpaceX commentators said the primary goal of the flight, testing the hot staging system for separating the upper and lower stages, appeared to work as planned. Likewise, all 33 Raptor engines in the Super Heavy and the 6 powering the Starship appeared to fire normal for as long as the vehicles were visible. How other upgrades implemented in the wake of the April failure performed Saturday remains to be seen. NASA is spending billions for a variant of the Starship to carry Artemis astronauts back to the surface of the moon. SpaceX is counting on the rocket to vastly expand its fleet of Starlink internet satellites and to power eventual low-cost government and commercial flights to the moon, Mars and beyond, in keeping with Musk's drive to make humanity a multi-planet species. Multiple test flights will be needed to demonstrate the reliability required for astronaut flights, and it's not yet clear how long that might take. While Saturday's launch was far from a complete success, it did demonstrate solid engine performance and successful stage separation. In the April flight, the pad was seriously damaged, the Super Heavy suffered multiple premature engine shutdowns, the stage separation system did not work and the rocket's self-destruct system took longer than expected to activate. The rocket reached a maximum altitude of 24 miles, well below the 50-mile altitude NASA considers the boundary of space, before tumbling back toward Earth and exploding in a fireball of burning propellant. The FAA investigated the failure and cited multiple root causes of the mishap and 63 corrective actions SpaceX must take to prevent mishap reoccurrence. Musk said the company implemented well over 1,000 changes to improve safety and performance. The company finally received the required FAA launch license earlier this week, after a final review of the rocket's possible impact on area wildlife. Along with hot staging, SpaceX added a powerful water deluge system to the launch pad, to reduce the acoustic shock of engine ignition, and the effects of their combined thrust. During the April launch, the base of the pad was heavily damaged, with steel and concrete debris blasted into the surrounding area. Other major upgrades include the replacement of hydraulic actuators, with an electrically driven engine steering system and an improved, faster-acting self-destruct system. Getting the Super Heavy Starship flying on a regular basis is critical to NASA's Artemis Moon program. NASA gave SpaceX a $2.9 billion contract in 2021 to develop a variant of the Starship upper stage to carry astronauts down to the lunar surface in the next 2 to 3 years. To send a Starship to the Moon, SpaceX must first refuel it in low Earth orbit, robotically transferring thousands of gallons of super-cold cryogenic propellants, carried up by multiple Starship tankers. The number of tankers required is not yet known, but senior NASA managers have said more than a dozen will be needed for each Starship sent to the Moon. NASA's contract requires one unpiloted lunar test flight before astronauts will make a landing attempt. Artemis managers continue to officially target late 2025 for the first lunar landing with astronauts on board, but that's not remotely feasible given SpaceX's pace developing the Starship system. It's also not known when SpaceX might be ready to launch paying customers aboard the new rocket. NASA's moon program aside, at least 3 all-civilian missions have been booked to date. Billionaire Jared Isaacman, who charted the first private Crew Dragon flight to low Earth orbit in 2019, plans to be aboard for the first piloted orbital flight of a Starship, as part of his Polaris Dawn program. Japanese billionaire Yusaka Maezawa, who paid the Russians for a visit to the International Space Station in 2021, also has chartered a Starship flight, Dear Moon, to carry him, an assistant and 10 artists and influencers on a privately funded Around the Moon voyage. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.